when you're talking to yourself.
Okay, we're down here now with Tom Heffernan. Welcome to On the Water, first of all, Tom.
Thank you very much.
Tom is one of the guys that builds a lot of the boats. You've built the three New Zealand boats that are here, and you've built your own boat, obviously. So, just quickly, maybe a couple of little technical bits and pieces. First of all, we're looking at a big fin down here. Tell us a little bit about what this big fin hanging off the left sponson does.
Okay, that's very similar to the ski boat style fin, which is in the middle. This one being on the outside here, because we only turn left, it grabs the water and holds the boat in the turn as you're going around.
Okay, and of course, if you're watching these boats, the big fin there tosses up an absolute truckload of water in the corner. It's very spectacular to watch.
Yes, it is. It's quite a lot of water. There's other bits to look for on the way around as you go around. The rooster tail off the boat as you're running along in a straight line, probably to the untrained eye. But if you have a look at it, and you see all these dark lines in it, that's each beat of the propeller blade. There's a dark line in the rooster tail.
They're unbelievable things to watch, so people should get down and have a look at them. Now, another great safety development in hydroplane racing over the years, of course, many years ago, a lot of guys were getting killed in boats in open cockpits, but these boats now have what we call a safety cell in them. Tell us all about that.
Yeah, well, the safety cell these boats here, there is an inner and outer. The inner one is 8 layers of carbon fibre, half-inch foam sandwich in the same layup again. Then there's a chrome molly roll cage over the front and around each side of it to keep keep other people out. And then there's the outer cell.
Okay, and obviously, what is the actual idea of the safety cell? Obviously, you're strapped in. What stops you from drowning?
We have an onboard air system, which is the large bottle on the back of the boat here. It's fairly good. It's got 45 minutes of air, but it lasts about 20 minutes when you're racing because you just start to hyperventilate and start to breathe really heavy. But it's clipped, the mask is clipped onto my helmet, and I breathe it at all times while you're in the boat.
So obviously the key is to not get injured, first of all in an impact, and then once you're not injured, you're able to extricate yourself out of the boat and be safe.
Yeah, well, that's right. If the boat's upside down and you're trapped inside, you can't breathe water, so you've got to breathe something. Then you've got a chance and you can open up the hatch underneath the boat and climb out if someone's around.
Well, Tom, you've built, as I said, not only this boat, the three New Zealand boats that are competing here this weekend. I think you might have a little bit of a vested interest. You might be happy if you win. You might even be happy if those sheep likers over there have a bit of a win as well. So a bit of a vested interest there, mate.
Yeah, it is. It's pretty good. There's not a lot of people build them anymore, and to build the boats that won the Griffith Cup before, that won the World Series, the A.E. Baker, that style of thing, I'm pretty proud.
Tom Heffernan, the driver of the GP7, the Dragula. Thanks for having a chat with us and giving us a little bit of an insight into Grand Prix hydroplanes, Tom.
Thank you very much.
Ken Lupton from Annihilate 3. Ken, you're 19 years old and driving a GP Hydro. How's that going?
Well, it's pretty uncommon, but seem to be doing all right so far. I haven't killed myself yet, but a few problems today. We're trying to get through it at the moment and slowly get in there.
Now, the three Annihilators all out of the same shed, under the same umbrella. They're all going frantic. What's going on?
We've got three boats from New Zealand out of the same shed at home. Brought six engines over. I've heard an engine just in the practice then. We're changing engine at the moment. Other two boats are pretty good at the moment. They seem to be on song. And I'm in heat three, and the other boats are all in separate heats, one, two, and three, and we'll see how we go after the heats.
No worries at all, mate. Good luck out there on the course, and give it plenty. I'm sure you will.
Don't worry about my foot a bit of the middle. Don't worry about that. Me tapped.
We have Warwick Lupton, driver of Annihilator 1 and the crew chief of the three Annihilator boats. Mate, welcome to On the Water.
Yeah, thanks very much, mate.
Now, mate, there's a bit of problems going on here with the other boats. I noticed that there's no one working on yours. You've got the tarp over it at the moment. She must all be good.
Yeah, no, she's looking pretty sweet, eh? It's, we've done all we can do for her, and she can't pull it off on the water now. Well, it's done its thing.
Now, you're over here to try and drag the cup back over to the land along the white cloud. What do you think your chances are?
Well, the way we're looking at the moment, pretty limited. But, yeah, first you've got to get into this final heat. So our ambition is to qualify. If we can qualify and we can get a good start, we'll give them a run for their money, we think.
Yeah, no worries at all, mate. Good luck out there.
Thanks very much.
Here we have Dave Alexander of Annihilator 2, mate. Welcome to On the Water, firstly.
How we going? Good, thank you.
That's good. Now, mate, how do you get a ride in that?
Oh, I just sort of, my cousin Warwick actually gave me the boat a few years ago to drive, and just ever since then we've carried on to the season for a bit of experience to see if I enjoyed it, so I've just carried on from then, really.
Yeah, right. So you got the opportunity, mate, and you held up to it.
Yeah, well, I've done it for my sixth season now. I come over here in 2001 and been here. This is my fourth time to Australia, and here we run second in 2001 to Warwick. He won it, and the last couple of times we've come over, we've gone quite so good. We made the final last year and got third, but yeah, we'd like to take the number one spot, obviously, this year.
Oh, of course. Now, what sort of horsepower is your engine's putting out?
Oh, around the 1500 to 1300, around there, my boat is. The engine I've got on at the moment is about 1300 horsepower. Bet you heard our good engine yesterday, but that's all pretty good. I think we're going to make enough power with this one to hopefully pull it off, but we'll see what happens.
Now, they tell me the Yarrawonga water's a little bit rough. What's it like to conditions back home?
Yeah, it's a lot rougher than what we're used to at Karapiro, where our main home track is. It's probably some of the best water in the world for hydroplane racing, but the roughness is the same for everyone. You've just got to drive the conditions and still be doing a fair bit of speed out there. Like, the rough water sometimes actually going quicker in because it dispenses the air under the boat, so you can actually go a lot faster.
No worries. Good on you, Dave. Good luck, mate. We'll see you out in the water.
Thank you.
Okay, we're down here with the current E.C. Grifith Cup title holder, Matt Ferris, the driver of Tadu. Matt, first of all, congratulations on last year's Grifith Cup defence title. Now, tell us a little bit about your boat.
Our boat's a KT boat. It's a tunnel boat. It's a long sponson hydroplane, a little bit different to the other GP boats that are here. It's running supercharged big block Chev motor, around about 1200 horsepower with a stern drive unit. It's a little bit tighter on the corners than the big hydro boats, but a lot faster around the corner.
The boat was out this morning, it looked very settled though. Is that an advantage of the KT tunnel type hull?
Yeah, they're a very easy boat to settle, and they don't get upset by rough water very easily, so they maintain their course over rough or smooth.
And what sort of top speed will you be seeing out of the boat, Matt?
It's hard to say today. We'll drive it as we need to, but worst case scenario, we'll drive it flat out. It'll pull 170 miles an hour. If we don't have to, we'd rather sort of stick it down around about 150 miles an hour and see how we go.
Well, mate, you won it last year. You're backing up again this year to do it. Good luck. The boat's good. It looks good. It's ready to go. All we can say is good luck, and hope you can pull another E.C. Grifith Cup.
Thank you very much.
Thanks, mate. Dean Gleeson, pilot of the Fly. Mate, firstly, welcome to On the Water. Secondly, mate, tell us a bit about the boat. It's a displacement hull. How are you going to go against the hydro boys?
Well, probably going to have a bit of a tough time in the first corner today because we've got two very large hydros and they're quite fast on the inside of me, as well as one of the KT boats. So put it this way, I have to nail a start. There's no other way.
Right, now you're going to be taking different lines on, taking it to the hydros and even to the tunnel boats.
I need to get to the boys first. I need to get around those boys before the hydros get there.
Right, so you'll be in there, and once you're in there, you'll be cutting around the boys a lot tighter than the hydros and then belting it back up the straight, easing it off coming into the boys, is that right?
That's exactly right. I'll drive from pin to pin, whereas the hydros are driving a big circle around the outside, and just got to make sure you don't get caught in their tail wash.
Right, I can understand that, mate. They're throwing out a fair bit of water. What sort of horsepower is the engine putting out?
Around 1200 horsepower. Runs about 25 pounds of boost.
Right, so once you've actually got your foot into this, we should expect to see the boat dancing a little bit.
I've tied it up a bit this morning. It was a bit loose yesterday, so I've tied it up a bit this morning, and it'll be all right.
No worries, Dean. Good luck out there, mate, and hope the Griffith Cup stays in Australia.
So do I. That's why we're here. Thanks, Go Man.
Good on you, mate. Thank you.
Here we have John Cross, pilot of Bad Medicine. Firstly, John, welcome to On the Water.
Yeah, thanks a lot.
Now, mate, if paint jobs are anything to go by, this thing should absolutely fly. It's a beautifully turned out boat.
Yeah, it's a nice boat. It's a boat that I drove here last year and sort of held the Kiwis off for about 2.5 laps until the propeller braid broke. But a mate of mine, he's bought it now and wants to start racing. So it should be good.
Mate, what sort of motor you got in it?
It's about a 560 cube Chev. It's probably putting out about 1500 horsepower.
Geez, that's a bit of bum clenching stuff really, isn't it?
It certainly is, mate, yes.
Mate, when you're getting it up dancing and hitting the wake off other boats, hey, what are you doing? I mean, you've got nothing really holding you in there except your grip on the steering wheel.
Yeah, mate, just bang the ass cheeks together and just hold on and go for it.
And you'll be getting out of bad medicine?
This time last year, they were clocking me about 152 mile an hour, so I would hope to be doing at least that.
Well, you're going to need to be doing that. Now, you're going to have to be taking different lines to the hydros?
Yes. Last year, they turn up big waves in the apex of the corners, so you don't want to be going over those because they're about, you know, 3-4 foot deep. So I'll just run a bit wider into the corners and try and miss the waves to get a clean run through. So you can get out and go hard out of the corners.
Got any sneaky plans for not letting the Kiwis take it back at home that you can share with us?
Of course, mate. Just cut them off at the start. It should be sweet.
I like your work, Crossy. Good luck out there, mate. We hope to chat to you soon.
Yeah, thanks a lot, Caveman. Thanks.